Hello, this is Darren DePaul, the voice of Emperor Valkorion, and you're watching another video by Valk.
How about we explore a little bit this new area on Odessen? It doesn't feature many things, just that locked area that you would need to unlock. If I go there and attempt to click it, you see that the trader's quarters are currently unavailable. Why? Because I need the vendors. I'll show you the vendors in a moment. Before that, very quick look at the new terminal available here. Once again, these three versions, Story, Veteran, and Master, are normal versions of the Flashpoint where you don't get spoilers about who the traitor is. The cinematics are different and much shorter, and many of the voiceover lines during the gameplay are actually either missing or also different. So, if you have a low-level character because Veteran is available from 15 to 70, 15 to 69 get bolstered, you don't need to worry about spoiling for yourself anything about the true story continuation from 5.4. You're just doing a generic Flashpoint where you will see some cutscenes, but they don't actually make much sense. They're different cutscenes with much less voiceover and not really a part of the story. And now let's do the fun part. I was really waiting for these 2 hours since the live stream has started. I wanted to show and tell you the contents of the new vendors. These are the 2 new vendors available here with the release of patch 5.4. Let's start with Nessie Vakan. She's selling, I don't know if I want to call it a brand new outfit, but to some of you it might be new. I think it's a replica with, please, tell me if it's a replica. I don't know to this day. I'm not really sure if it's a replica or a brand new outfit. It does seem familiar to me, but I'm not a huge fan of outfits. Skorks has been wearing this outfit since 3.0. Volk has been wearing his outfit for 4.5 years. My Commando and Sage have been wearing the same outfit since the first time they reached level 50 and obtained those Rakata sets, and you get the point. So this is the new outfit, a very weird looking helmet of an Umbaran soldier. Well, the whole armor is actually a replica of the Umbaran soldier. You say it's new, okay, I'll believe you, thank you for that. They are quite expensive, look at this, 10 tokens for the chest piece plus 500,000 credits. 8 tokens for the boots, 8 for the gloves and 300,000 credits. What is it? The pants and the helmet cost you 500,000 again and 10 tokens again. And these are the items that you can afford from just running the Flashpoint once. The bracer and the wrist. Down below we've got the interesting thing. Invitation Trader's Quarters. This thing will set you back 10,000 credits and 60 Alliance Recon data. We've talked about already, but just in case you are watching this standalone highlighted portion of my long live stream, you need 10 runs in solo mode, 6 runs in veteran mode, or 3 runs in master mode, defeating all 4 boss encounters, because we've got 3 normal boss encounters and one that's kind of a bonus encounter, bonus boss in between the first and the second bosses. So you will need this in order to gain access to this place. This is actually the terminal that will give you the new Umbara mobile base. Replica of the train that we just hijacked in the beginning of the Flashpoint crisis on Umbara. Down below we've got the Iocat Recombinator costing you 5 tokens and 10,000 credits. This item will be needed in conjunction with the next vendor that we're about to take a look at. This is a really good looking mount, and I think 2 million is good enough price for this thing. It also costs 15 of the Flashpoint tokens, unfortunately. Which means if you want to unlock all of these things from the vendor, you will need to actually sleep and live inside the Flashpoint for at least a few days. Now, let's move on to the next vendor. This guy is selling very special attack adrenals and some stims down below for the exact same price. Each one of those will cost you 4 Flashpoint tokens and 75,000 credits. What is good about these things? They're in stats. They're exactly the same as your normal stims that you can craft as biochem, but the trick is they don't expire. If you have been active in this game for long enough, you probably remember that At some point, Bauer decided to remove the non-consumable items from the game for, let's not go back and explain all of their reasons. They were good reasons. For whatever reason, they decided to bring them back. I think it's a slight issue because it might actually cause some trouble with crew skills, diversity, and forcing some players to choose a specific crew skill because they would want this. So, once again, there are all of the Adrenals available, and all of the Steams are also available here from this vendor, which means you can craft this once and keep using it over and over and over for your character once you've crafted it. Or you can trade it to someone else. Thank you for watching. I hope you have enjoyed the video.